I'm gonna make the simple drift rig for you real fast. So we're gonna do a quick snell again. Run that down to the end of the shank where it bends. Wrap it 10 times. Do about 3.5-4 feet of line. Run that through the back. Cinch it nice and tight so you get a nice snell. You don't need that much tag, so you might want to cut that off. But leave some so it doesn't pull through. What I do, because we don't fish for 50-pound and 80-pound blue cats or flats, to keep this simple, is I do something unconventional because I don't want to deal with the slip knot. The slip knots seem to fail. About 1.5-2 inches up, I tie a couple knots. That becomes my bobber stop for the drift. Quick and easy. Next goes a bead. These are 8mm beads. Next goes the float. Next goes the bead. Do an improved cinch on the swivel. Through the hole, back through the hole, pull it tight, improve cinch, clip the tag, come back to the business end, push the bead in the bobber, push this bead in the bobber, float, whatever you want to call it. Some people glue these. If you buy the right size, you don't need to glue them. I have not had a problem with them. But there you go. There's your float. Some people tie a knot on there. You don't really need to. A little knot right there on that tag. Don't really need to. I haven't had any problems with that. But that works. If you're fishing for bigger fish, you might want to reconsider this knot. Could be a failure point. But 30-pound channel cats, not a problem.